Tonight on NewsWatch, a Tea Party giant suddenly steps down in the Senate. What will it mean for the conservative cause in Congress?
Plus, marriage in the balance from Washington State to Washington, D.C. America's shifting stand on the future of the family.
And Christian teenagers hooked on pornography, the internet's devastating impact on the next generation. All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. A conservative standard bearer is leaving Capitol Hill. Good evening, I'm Lee Webb.
And I'm Wendy Griffith. Staunch conservative Senator Jim DeMint announced today he is leaving Congress. The South Carolina Republican is resigning to take over at the Heritage Foundation. In recent years, DeMint has been one of the most outspoken and steadfast conservative voices in the Senate. He's been on board with the Tea Party movement, standing up to Republican Party leaders. DeMint even supported Tea Party efforts to replace some Republican incumbents with more conservative candidates. Conservatives say his exit will be a big loss for them in the Senate, but a big gain for the Heritage Foundation and the overall conservative movement. CBN's congressional correspondent John Jessup joins us now with reaction from Capitol Hill. John, DeMint's departure really sent a shockwave through Washington. What are people on the Hill saying?
Well, you know, despite the ongoing talks for the fiscal cliff, it's a really slow legislative day here on Capitol Hill. So this, of course, is the big news, not just the big news of the day, but the big news of the week, really. And there is shock, as you just mentioned. You know, I think a lot of it has to do with the timing. Senator DeMint was just reelected 2 years ago, really had four more years before he was up for reelection. He's been a strong conservative voice. So I think for many people, it was initially shock just because of the fact that he had four more years to be a leading conservative voice in the Senate. However, once people got past the initial shock of his statement, his departure, and started focusing on what he would be doing next as the head of the Heritage Foundation, I think more people began to see that this was a natural fit for him, going to the largest conservative think tank in America. And, you know, once that started to set in, you had people began to wish him well and, of course, suggest that they're going to miss his conservative leadership on Capitol Hill. But even as he said in a statement departing Capitol Hill, he said, "I'm leaving the Senate, but I'm not leaving the fight."
Interesting. Well, as you mentioned, he was one of the most conservative Republicans in the Senate. How much of an impact will this have in the upper chamber, his departure?
Of course, a leading conservative voice. He's been out front against Obamacare. He's been out front in trying to recruit conservatives just like him to Congress. And that has caused a little bit of friction between him and establishment Republicans. But, you know, he's been able to really advance the cause for advocating for economic liberty, advocating against government overreach with new federal regulations. And he's recruited people like Mike Lee and Ron Johnson to form a Tea Party caucus here on Capitol Hill within the Senate. And here's what some of his colleagues had to say, some of his conservative colleagues had to say about his leaving. Mike Lee from Utah said that Jim has been a source of inspiration for many of us who came to Washington to fight for our conservative beliefs. Jim is a friend and mentor, and I plan to honor his time in the Senate by continuing the push for individual liberty and restoring constitutional government. Jeff Duncan, his colleague from South Carolina in the House, said whoever takes Jim's place in the Senate will have large shoes to fill. I'll be praying for Governor Haley that Jim has fought so hard, praying for Governor Haley, rather, to select a leader who believes in the principles that Jim has fought so hard to defend. So you have these two conservative leaders saying that they will continue Jim's fight.
Well, John, we know that Senator DeMint has often been at odds with Senate Republican leaders. How much of that inner party battle would you say played a role in his decision to resign?
Well, you know, there's no secret that there has been some fallout between DeMint and Republican leadership in the Senate. Some of them blame him for not being able to secure more seats in the Senate because he backed candidates that were seen as too conservative and not mainstream enough. So, you know, he wasn't given a slot in Senate leadership, so perhaps that did play a role. Talking to his staff today, they say that they feel like he'd be able to do more to advance conservative principles outside than within the Senate. And just speaking of that outsider status, I want to mention back in October, he gave a speech to the Heritage Foundation talking a little bit about when he first came to Washington, how then Majority Leader Tom DeLay had urged Republicans to vote for a bill that he described as bad legislation. And this is what he had to say about it.
I was sitting there and I was a freshman and I just kind of yelled out, that's completely illogical. And, you know, everybody was staring at me and the room was quiet. And somebody from the back of the room just said, "Don't worry, you'll get used to it." Well, I never got used to it.
So he never got used to it, and now he'll be playing that agitator role just outside of Congress and with the Heritage Foundation.
All right, John Jessup on Capitol Hill for us tonight. Thanks so much, John.
Thank you.
It is a big week in the battle over marriage in America. Homosexual activists are celebrating the legalization of same-sex marriage in Washington state today. In Washington, D.C., the U.S. Supreme Court may be about to finally weigh in on what marriage really is. Mark Martin has more.
Do you swear or affirm that the information on your application is true and correct?
Yes.
Hundreds of gay and lesbian couples have been getting marriage licenses in Washington state today, after the state's governor signed a law approved by the voters that legalizes homosexual marriage. The state has a 3-day waiting period before weddings can take place.
We have the license.
There it is.
3 days. I think we can make it another 3 days.
9 states and the District of Columbia have redefined marriage. Will the Supreme Court follow suit? The court is expected to announce Friday morning if it will hear 2 major cases that could have far-reaching impacts on the definition of marriage in the U.S. One of those cases deals with the Federal Defense of Marriage Act, or DOMA. The other, Proposition 8, California's voter-approved gay marriage ban. DOMA defines marriage for all purposes, including federal benefits, as between a man and a woman. 4 federal district courts and 2 appeals courts have overturned it. Pro-family advocates say the stakes are high.
This is fundamentally a religious liberty question. You redefine marriage, you redefine it for everyone. And the law will be used to punish and marginalize those of us that believe marriage is the union of a man and a woman. It's already happening.
If the Supreme Court does strike down DOMA, same-sex marriage advocates say the decision would send a message that all marriages are equal under the law. Court watchers think the justices also will take up Prop 8. 2 federal courts have struck it down as discriminatory.
And we're not fighting a battle against gay individuals. We're all children of God. We respect and love everyone. But marriage is something that God created to bring men and women together and to protect children.
Voters in 31 states have amended their constitutions to prohibit homosexual marriage, with North Carolina being the most recent in May. Trying to build on recent wins at the ballot box, gay marriage supporters are now targeting several states for voting drives, including New Jersey, Delaware, Illinois, and Rhode Island. Mark Martin, CBN News.
Tufts Christian Fellowship is again recognized as a student religious group at Tufts University in Boston. TCF is a chapter of InterVarsity Christian Fellowship. The group was told it violated the school's non-discrimination policy by requiring its leaders to follow basic biblical truths of Christianity. InterVarsity leaders appealed the school's decision to remove its official recognition, and the Tufts University Committee on Student Life ruled in their favor. Planned Parenthood was the most effective political group in this year's elections. A new study by the Sunlight Foundation shows Planned Parenthood succeeded in 98% of its campaign efforts. The nation's biggest abortion provider spent about $15 million supporting and opposing candidates. The Washington Post reports that is triple the amount the group spent in 2008. They focus mainly on defeating Mitt Romney and conservative candidates in the swing states, telling voters they would take away women's reproductive choices and benefits. The group threw its support behind President Obama, who fought heavily to keep taxpayer funding for Planned Parenthood.
A private company in Pennsylvania is joining a long list of companies and religious groups filing suit against the Obama administration. The lawsuit over the Obamacare contraception insurance mandate. The company's owners are Christians. Their attorney says it's un-American for the federal government to force people of faith to violate their conscience. Under the mandate, their family-owned wood product company will be forced to offer insurance coverage of contraceptives to employees January 1st. Attorneys fighting the mandate on religious institutions say they welcome privately owned businesses joining the fight.
Just because they're a secular employer or just because they're a nonprofit employer, but they may not be specifically focused on everything they do relative to religion or Christianity or any other faith, doesn't mean that they are now excluded from the protections of the Constitution or federal law.
The mandate on religious-affiliated groups is expected to make it to the Supreme Court.
One of America's top economists says Congress needs to do away with the debt ceiling law. Moody's economist Dr. Mark Zandi told members of the Joint Economic Committee today that only honest tax and spending policies will keep America from the fiscal cliff.
This is a really bad way of doing things. We need to get rid of this. And now, having said that, we need budget rules. We need to be able to figure out a way to try to be credible in terms of what we're saying about future tax and spending policy. But this approach, the debt ceiling approach, is just the wrong way of doing it.
Meanwhile, Treasury Secretary Timothy Geithner says the Obama administration is absolutely willing for the U.S. economy to go over the fiscal cliff rather than accept a deal that doesn't include higher tax rates for top earners. As the Washington stalemate continues, Americans across the country are preparing for what could be a year, a very tough new year. For example, in North Carolina, Social Security workers are facing automatic cuts in January if Washington fails to act.
Employees will be facing 15 to 40 days worth of furlough, meaning they won't be in the office. We already are backlogged at the hearings level.
And many jobless Americans will no longer receive unemployment checks in January if no deal is struck.
Turning now to the political crisis in Egypt, the Egyptian army deployed tanks outside the presidential palace in Cairo. The move came after clashes between supporters and opponents of the president claimed five lives. The fighting centers over the sweeping new powers Mohamed Morsi gave himself and a proposed constitution that will greatly expand Sharia law throughout Egypt. Here's Chris Mitchell.
The street violence pits the Muslim Brotherhood and supporters of President Morsi against many youth and liberal groups. Hundreds have been wounded in the fighting. Opposition leaders have formed a group called the National Salvation Front.
We are going to continue protesting in every possible way, including a general strike, until we regain our rights and our freedom and we correct the course of the revolution. The regime, in my opinion, and the opinion of many of us here, is losing its legitimacy day after day.
The BBC reported Morsi may soon address the nation. On Wednesday, three more of his advisors resigned in protest. Muslim Brotherhood leaders are calling for a dialogue, but the opposition says certain conditions must first be met.
We are ready for a serious dialogue on the specific basis that he first cancel the constitutional declaration, and then seriously deal with the role of the people and their right to discuss and influence the constitution.
A national vote on the proposed constitution is scheduled for December 15th. Opposition leaders might decide to either campaign against the referendum or call for a boycott. Egyptian analyst Samuel Tadros wrote the proposed constitution includes an article that would be disastrous for Christians. He wrote, "This article affects Christian religious endowments. It places church finances under the Islamist control, which has been part of the Muslim Brotherhood's Freedom and Justice Party political program. By taking control of the church's finances, the Islamists aim to control the institution and in turn use it to control Christians." Given the specter of this proposed constitution and in the midst of this national crisis, many Egyptian Christians are asking for prayer from Christians around the world. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Coming up, good grief, Charlie Brown. Why an atheist is trying to keep school children from seeing the Peanuts Christmas classic.
It's probably something I've had for many years, and every year the PSA would be a little higher. I just kept kind of ignoring it. You know, one of those guy things. It'll go away. Finally, one day, Janet says, "You're going to the doctor." They did a blood test. My PSA was 14. I needed to get a second opinion, so we contacted Cancer Treatment Centers of America.
To find out more about Cancer Treatment Centers of America and our unique treatment options for complex and advanced stage cancer, go to cancercenter.com.
The really great thing is that you just go online, and if you have prostate or lung cancer or whatever, you can see what their survival rates are.
You can also check for participating insurance plans. Cancer Treatment Centers of America is different. You feel it the moment you call or walk into one of our hospitals. It's state-of-the-art medicine, unique treatment options, and a level of compassion that cannot be copied. Why? Our people. People who give you not only their expertise, but their humanity and the most thoughtful, well-organized, patient-centered care you'll find anywhere.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America go way beyond what normal hospitals do. I knew that they had the technology to take care of my cancer. It's a device called Calypso.
Calypso is GPS for the prostate. We're able to get four-dimensional real-time tracking of prostate movement during radiation treatment.
It eliminates a lot of my side effects. It makes sense. It just makes sense. I own a deli. I'm back at work. My customers come in and say, gosh, you look good. And some of them say I look better now than I did before I left. I didn't expect to learn a lesson about how to treat people by being in a hospital. You can tell when somebody really cares.
Every minute counts when you're fighting complex or advanced stage cancer. So please call or visit cancercenter.com today. Appointments are available now. Cancer Treatment Centers of America, care that never quits.
An Arkansas church canceled a performance of Merry Christmas, Charlie Brown after a complaint by an atheist group. Terry Elementary School in Little Rock, Arkansas planned an optional school trip to go see the play, but a parent complained and took the issue to the Arkansas Society of Free Thinkers. It says students should not be exposed to a show with Christian themes as part of a school field trip.
I mean, it's Charlie Brown. I was raised, I saw it as a child as well in my home, which most people will be able to do.
The teachers wanted to provide a cultural opportunity for the students through a holiday production.
The church pastor says he doesn't think they were doing anything wrong, but wanted to avoid the controversy and canceled the show. Religious groups have held a live nativity scene in front of the United States Supreme Court and the Capitol building. Faith in Action and the Christian Defense Coalition want to promote public Christmas displays. They say the Nativity Project is a reminder that the Constitution provides freedom of religion. Reverend Patrick Mahoney says if the coalition could get a permit to display a nativity scene in front of the Supreme Court, every person should be able to display one in their own community.
A fourth-year cadet at West Point is dropping out less than 6 months before graduation. Blake Page says he can no longer be part of a culture that promotes prayers and religious activities. He says West Point disrespects non-religious cadets like himself, and he's leaving as a protest against what he calls an unconstitutional practice of religion in the military. West Point officials deny Page's charges. A spokeswoman says prayer is voluntary at events. The Miami-Dade Commission has voted to reinstate prayer at its public meetings. The prayers were banned 8 years ago. The prayers must be non-denominational and offered before the meeting officially begins. The bill's sponsor says it's a matter of freedom of speech.
Up next, it may seem sexy, but actually it's ruining sex. Hear about this vice and how it's literally warping American minds.
Listen up for an amazing offer that can change the way you hear.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. Can you repeat that?
Frustrated with your hearing?
What did he say?
Well, hear better now. Introducing the fully rechargeable MSA30X, a revolutionary device that features the latest microsound amplification technology that can barely be seen. Independently tested to help you hear up to 30 times better. It turns ordinary hearing into extraordinary hearing. MSA30X works by capturing and amplifying sound waves. Yet it's lightweight, ergo-acoustic. Acoustic design is discreet. It form fits in and around either ear.
I forget I'm even wearing it.
And MSA30X is powerful. Hear clearly in restaurants. Never miss another word on TV or at the movies.
My wife complains that I have the volume up on the TV too loud.
And I didn't want to be in the same room with them.
Now I can hear everything clearly.
Simply adjust the volume as you desire. Other units use so many batteries, and they're difficult to change. But MSA30X is completely rechargeable. Simply plug it into the wall.
I tried other devices that had batteries, but they were always such a pain to change and so costly. But this is rechargeable, so I figure I save hundreds a year.
Not hearing the way you should? Don't settle for bulky sound amplifiers that can cost hundreds when you can try MSA30X for just $39.95. But wait, in this special Apple TV offer. We'll cut the price in half. Did you hear that? In half. It's the MSA 30X Here Better Now offer. For a limited time, just $19.95. And it's backed by a money-back guarantee. As an extra bonus with your charging base, we'll also include a cleaning brush and five soft comfort tips. The MSA 30X Here Better Now offer. Just $19.95.
All I can say is just try it. It could change your life.
Call or go online today.
To order the MSA 30X Sound Amplifier, call 1-800-920-1526. That's 1-800-920-1526 or go to buymsa30x.com. Call now.
Well, teens today are growing up in a society filled with pornography. It's easier than ever to find, thanks to the internet.
And many teens are becoming addicted. As Paul Strand reports, that addiction could ruin their lives.
The numbers are staggering. $100 billion worth of porn bought every year. 12% of the world's websites offer the illicit material. And each day, 2.5 billion pornographic emails whiz through cyberspace. And possibly most astounding of all, 67% of men and 49% of women say porn is acceptable.
Our society's just saturated with it.
Former addict C.J. Hitz got hooked at age 8. He says on average, kids first run into porn online at 11 years old. 90% of kids and teens admit they viewed it online, most while doing homework.
Now it's accessible to everyone.
Aubrey Terry's exposure came along with almost constant sexual abuse from her grandfather and an uncle from when she was 2 till she was rescued at 9. Her earliest memory?
Having a bottle and being exposed to that kind of stuff.
Now a member of the Human Trafficking Task Force of Southern Colorado, Terry puts a lot of the blame for today's X-rated epidemic on the internet.
Before, pornography was like this dirty, secretive, dark subculture. It's everyday life.
And it's there all the time. Every second, 28,000 people are online looking, and the sales ring up at $3,000 each second.
Today's generation, younger generation, receives more temptations per second than any other generation in the history of mankind.
So when it comes to pornography in our kids, in this hyper-fast, hyper-technological age, it's not a matter of temptation coming at them every once in a while, but almost every second, and with every device.
Addiction also claimed CJ's wife, Shelly, for a while. They both now minister to free people from an addiction that's constantly available.
And I'll have teenagers that will confess to me that they have their phones in their beds with them at night, and they're sexting. They're sending pictures of themselves to others. They're sending sexually graphic messages.
And this is hitting just as hard inside the church as out. Youth Minister Andy Brainer learned that disturbing truth after criticizing a friend for offering porn channels at his Florida hotel chain.
And he goes, well, you know, to be honest with you, he goes, you know who the biggest consumers of this pornography is? And I was like, what? And he named a certain denomination. He said, when they do their convention down here, my sale in pornography goes through the roof.
Brainer ministers to tens of thousands of Christian teens on the road and at a youth camp he leads near Durango, Colorado.
90% of the kids that come to us that come from Christian families that are interested in Christian values, that are learning about Christian worldview, 90% of those are deeply addicted to pornography.
As Shelley did research for a book on the addiction, she surveyed Christian women and girls and found many producing their own porn by sexting.
Their Christian teen girls, 21% admitted to sending a naked photo of themselves to someone else through their cell phone.
It's almost like you don't want to send me that picture. Why? Everyone else does. I've asked your friend, she sent it.
And this addiction can be just as bad as the hardest drugs. The group Fight the New Drug shows this video about how the brain releases addictive levels of pleasurable chemicals when a person sexually satisfies themselves with porn. Synaptic paths formed in the brain call out for more and more of this satisfaction.
A kid that is addicted to pornography or starts looking at pornography at 13, 14, 15 years old begins this synaptical connection in the brain that it's like a muscle, it's like working out. It becomes stronger the more that you work it.
The addicted brain then develops stronger cravings for harder stuff to get the same level of satisfaction. And nowadays, it's right there waiting on the internet. Experts sounded the alarm recently at the Christian Witherspoon Institute.
A teen today can access hardcore material that 15 years ago, a seasoned purveyor of pornography would have had a hard time to acquire.
Therapist Jill Manning says this is detrimental and dangerous.
When is a human being ready to process a rape scene, torture, bestiality, incest, child pornography?
It's ruining the way many young men now look at women.
There's no question that now a woman is something to be of conquest.
We're missing her spirituality, we're missing her beauty, we're missing her strengths because we're only desiring one piece.
And studies are showing it's making many men and women almost incapable of enjoying sex with their own real-life partners.
There is increased risk of separation and divorce. There's less sensitivity in their marriages. There's decreased sexual satisfaction and decreased sexual relations.
So the teens of today need to realize they may be risking their own future marriages.
Pornography used to be something so dark and scandalous it was kept in the shadows. What's going to happen to our kids in a world where it's omnipresent, available anywhere, anytime? Paul Strand, CBN News, reporting from Colorado Springs, Colorado.
Listen up for an amazing offer that can change the way you hear.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. Can you repeat that?
Frustrated with your hearing?
What did he say?
Well, hear better now. Introducing the fully rechargeable MSA30X, a revolutionary device that features the latest microsound amplification technology that can barely be seen. Independently tested to help you hear up to 30 times better. It turns ordinary hearing into extraordinary hearing. MSA30X works by capturing and amplifying sound waves. Yet it's lightweight, ergo-acoustic. Acoustic design is discreet. It form fits in and around either ear.
I forget I'm even wearing it.
And MSA30X is powerful. Hear clearly in restaurants. Never miss another word on TV or at the movies.
My wife complains that I have the volume up on the TV too loud.
And I didn't want to be in the same room with him.
Now I can hear everything clearly.
Simply adjust the volume as you desire. Other units use so many batteries, and they're difficult to change. But MSA30X is completely rechargeable. Simply plug it into the wall.
I tried other devices that had batteries, but they were always such a pain to change and so costly. But this is rechargeable, so I figure I save hundreds a year.
Not hearing the way you should? Don't settle for bulky sound amplifiers that can cost hundreds when you can try MSA30X for just $39.95. But wait, in this special TV offer, we'll cut the price in half. Did you hear that? In half. It's the MSA30X Hear Better Now offer. For a limited time, just $19.95. And it's backed by a money-back guarantee. As an extra bonus with your charging base, we'll also include a cleaning brush and five soft comfort tips. The MSA30X Hear Better Now offer, just $19.95.
All I can say is just try it. It could change your life.
Call or go online today.
To order the MSA30X sound amplifier, call 1-800-920-1526. That's 1-800-920-1526, or go to buymsa30x.com. Call now.
Singing carols at Christmas is nothing out of the ordinary.
But caroling underground definitely breaks with tradition. Musicians in central Wisconsin have started a new tradition of performing at one of the state's natural caverns. The holiday concerts are known as Caroling in the Cave. It started 6 years ago when a singing group toured the Cave of Mounds.
So we thought, what a great way to have a charity event, give a chance for some local musicians to have a very unusual venue for a concert.
Like, you know, being in this old place in the old earth, listening to these old songs, it was fantastic.
You bet. Visitors sang along as candles lit the walls and set the mood. That cavern was discovered in the late 1930s when miners were looking, blasting for limestone, and they discovered it. It really is a beautiful sound, isn't it?
And the sound was really wonderful. It added some richness to it.
What great acoustics.
Great experience. Mm-hmm. Well, that's going to do it for this edition of NewsWatch.
Thanks for joining us. Good night.
Good night.